I'm here with Julie Sherrato with Furry Friends Rock and Rescue and Toby.
Toby says Happy New Year to everybody, and it's a really happy new year for this little 27-pound ball of love.
Yeah.
We are getting so many apps for small animals, small dogs, and we have fosters for small dogs. So one of our goals for 2021 is to try to help more states and more shelters with kill on the back end because they're too full with small animals. So we're really going to try to pull more small animals now that we've got a transport crew from out of state.
Wow.
It's been crazy.
Yeah, tell us about 2020.
Really
busy.
Yes, looking at numbers, you know, COVID pandemic, but yet fundraising's down, but numbers are up. And I think last night when I was talking to some of the girls, we were 710 animals adopted. Cats, dogs, bunnies, guinea pigs, bearded dragons. So we hit that 700.
Yeah.
And then on top of that number, we had 250 animals that we transported to from Montana to Minnesota to get them to other shelters and other rescues. So we were really proud of that. We started our trap neuter release. We had over 140 cats that we TNR'd. Between Bismarck, Mandan, and Lincoln impounds, we've pulled 155 animals. That's amazing for a group of volunteers. It made me cry last night. I was like, oh my gosh, look what we've done in 2020. And then yesterday, you know, the ball drops on us again, no pun intended. And thank you to Hairball Haven and for Bell's Sake. You know, we have to network. We had a terrible hoarding up north of Minot. We took another 8 to 10 cats last night.
Gosh.
They worked feverishly. For Bell's Sake, pulled 4. We had to euthanize a couple that were so sick.
Wow.
They were beyond help. And then Hairball Haven took about 8 to 10.
Wow.
So networking is so key from around the state.
Yeah.
So going forward in 2021, we're really going to bust it and try to do a lot of trap neuter return with cats. Even some of the vets are going to start tattooing, and which makes me feel good, and we can talk about that someday.
Sure.
But letting them know when cats come in again that we've already trapped them once and fixed them.
Right.
So, yeah, it makes us really feel proud as an organization. It just makes me almost want to cry that.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's like 1,300 and some animals that this crazy group of volunteers has helped. So it's only going to get crazier.
Well, Julie, you guys do such a great job. Alicia, you know, got her dog, Luna, and me, my cat, Hal.
Oh, we love you guys.
Yeah.
It takes an army, and not just people on the front end, but people on the back end. And, yeah, it really made it a great year for us. And I don't know how we keep going, but for some odd reason, this group is so passionate. They just keep doing it. So,
they sure are, and we are so grateful for you guys.
And you, too. Thank you, Josh.
Yeah, thank you, Julie, and thank you, Toby.
Thanks, Toby.
Yeah.
Looking for his new home here in the next week.
Yeah. Well, Tom, speaking of, you know, helping out our furry friends, the temperature should be good for, you know, stray cats or any dog, taking the dog out on a walk.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, you're right. The